Hi everyone, welcome to our talk. I'm Meng Mengcai, PhD JD Attorney at Law at New Wei Ming Law Group. So the topic of our talk today is the case summaries for H-1B approvals in 2018 and some explanation. As we know, now we are approaching the H-1B application for year 2019, okay, and for the new fiscal year, which the H-1B after approval, we know it will be effective by October 1st of this year. Well, in the past year, in 2018, we filed several dozens of H-1B applications, and some of them unfortunately did not pick up by the USCIS for processing. Well, the rest, the ones that were selected for processing, we have maintained approval rate of around 90%. Specifically, we have achieved approvals for more than 20 H-1B applications so far, including H-1B application we filed for our own employees. And there are some cases still pending. As we know, sometimes this can take a long time. Well, the majority of these applications were approved without request for evidence. Well, some were approved after we respond to the request for evidence or RFE. As we described in some of our other videos, you know, for H-1B, there are some key issues to pay attention, including, well, for the beneficiary, the individual will need to provide documents showing he or she has kept legal status in the U.S., also the CV, the transcript, the diploma, those documents. And for the company, there will need to be financial documents and also additional materials to show indeed that this is a specialty occupation which requires bachelor's degree or higher. This is very important. Most of our clients are relatively small companies. They have fewer than 10 employees, and this did not stop the approval of H-1B application. In general, well, as we know, a lot of times there's no premium processing available for H-1B application. So you can prepare the H-1B in February or March and then file the application to the USCIS in the beginning of April. After that, it may take several months for the USCIS to adjudicate and approve the application. The actual pending time for the application can be case by case. Our experience is the specialty occupation is a key issue that often appears in the RFE request. And one common reason that some H-1B applications got denied is because the company did not provide sufficient documents to show, well, it really exists, there's enough financial ability to pay all the employees, and there are enough sufficient specialty jobs that the employees in the company can work on. As long as those materials, evidence, are gathered and presented properly, usually the H-1B should be approved without problem. If you have additional questions regarding H-1B application in the new year, you can contact us for a free consultation. Thank you.